and a big hello to all my young student friends. I'm Ashwini Krishan, and on behalf of the Kanara Saraswat Association, I invite you all to this Convocation Day. As we all know, Kanara Saraswat Association has always been at the forefront of encouraging talent and celebrating success. Towards this end, today we have this Convocation Day. Before we start, I would like to call on stage Shri Kishore Masukar, Vice President KSA. Kishore Ma'am is also the host of today's Convocation Day. To join you on stage, I now call upon Honorary Secretary KSA, Shri Shiv Shankar Murneshwar. I would now request our Chairman KSA, Shri Jairam Ma'am, to please come on stage along with our Chief Guest, Dr. Urmila Thatte. I would now request Kishore Ma'am to please give the welcome speech.
Yeah, respected, Dr. Urmila Thatte, our chairman, Jairam Ambarkar Ma'am, and Secretary Shiv Shankar Ma'am, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, let me apologize you for some delay because there is really such a jam. I started Bandra from 4 to 5 and I reached just now here. So it was really totally jammed there. So I was also getting little panicky about it, why it is taking time. I welcome you all for this convocation from Kanara Saraswat Association, and it is called At Home. So I was not knowing initially when I became a vice president why it is called At Home. So now I realize that it is called At Home because Angela Chadamangala, Angela Ghar Kerel Kautuka. So that is why it is called At Home. So that is the whole concept behind it. And I really feel that it is a very historic thing because when I was inquiring, this At Home function is happening from 1940s and 50s. And every year, because as you know, our KSA is 106 year old, and this particular function to felicitate the children is happening for last 50 to 60 years. So can we imagine our great-grandfathers are sitting here with all the, to get the felicitation, you know, from then, dignitaries. So, and it is also, I think we found out one issue where Parampuja Anandashram Swamiji has also presided this function to felicitate the young graduates. So this all shows that how Amchi community we are so much education focused, you know, education focused, even from those days when we came from Karnataka and those parts here. So we were so education focused that we used to give so much importance to the education for even in those days. And that is why today why our community is so much ahead in so many spheres, in so many fields. We are always competing, though it's a small community. We are in the forefront in many areas of industry as well as in education and in so many other areas. And we should salute our forefathers for giving so much importance to the education. I have on a lighter note, I have a company friend who always, he is a GSP, Kamatan GSP, that side. He said, when the Chitrapur Saraswat father wants to see the alliance for his daughter, he said, Kal Shikla Kama. Whereas Angil Anki to do to Kamai Kama. So that is the difference between this thing. Ultimately, the thing is that how much successful one is in their life. So all the students who are here, as Swami Vivekananda has said, there are different paths in our life. There are different paths of success in our life. So you all have achieved, all the students, They have achieved one part of success, and that success will definitely lead to the other success and make you as a very successful, as well as your success will grow from one success. That is what it should be. You know that all this encouragement is for that. Today, when I'm talking about it, that this is not only the academic success that is important, but overall successful life is what is there, is all the student has to strive for. Today we have in our community itself, though it is a small community, you open everyday newspaper, you see Nanda Nilekani or you see Deepika Padukone. Deepika Padukone more these days because of her marriage, wedding and all. You know, they are all successful, from our community. I will tell you one small incident that when I went to Vienna for some work. And when I came out of the airport in Austria, I couldn't get the taxi stand, because of language problems and so many other things. I was a little worried, where to go and all. Suddenly I saw a big hoarding with Deepika Padukone on that, it was a watch advertisement. And then I have seen them in so many European countries. So there I felt at home. because we see our own somebody there. So that is what we call it success. And I wish that all our youngsters who will be felicitated here or who have done successfully in our community to become successful in their life, they will get more and more successes in their life. And I'm very grateful to today's Chief guest. She is also one of the most, Dr. Urmila Thatte is one of the most prominent clinical pharmacologists of our country. She is in the government, she has been appointed in the expert committee for the new drugs. She is a head of department of GS Medical College for clinical pharmacology. So she is a well-known figure who has done excellent in this, in her area of expertise. So let us, of course, I think Lakshmini is going to introduce her because she has got so many awards and so many this thing for her, honors for her. She is going to introduce her properly after me. And I again welcome you all and thank you so much for coming. Thank you.
Thank you, Kishore Ma'am. Now it gives me immense pleasure to tell you all about the various achievements of our chief guest, Dr. Urmila Thatte. Currently, she is a professor and head of department of clinical pharmacology in the St. G.S. Medical College at Cape Hospital. She is married to Dr. Mukund Thatte, who is a plastic surgeon attached to the Bombay Hospital for almost 36 years. They have two sons. The elder is a computer engineer and is currently in Goa, and the younger is a pediatrician who is also studying pediatric cardiology in Harvard. Dr. Urmila Thatte was born to late Sri Jamalabad Basant Rao and late Srimati Meera Jamalabad, who incidentally was a professor of math in Wilson College. She has a brother, Sri Anand Rao, who is married to Srimati Pratibha, and they too have two children. Education background is fantastic. She went to school in St. Columbus School, Mumbai first, thereafter St. Mary's School in Pune, and finally back to Bombay to Queen Mary's School, which incidentally is also my alma mater, so I'm truly feeling proud. Her college education was in Ruya College. She studied medicine in St. G.S. Medical College and including MD as well as PhD, both in pharmacology, and DNB in clinical pharmacology. She is a fellow of the National Medical Science Academy of New Delhi. She is on various prestigious committees under the Government of India, some subjects expert committees. She is also on an expert committee under the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. She is on the Scientific Advisory Committee as a clinical pharmacology expert. As we all know, in today's world, ethics counts a lot, not only in life but also in every profession. So, she is on the ethical review committees in India and also serves on other ethics committees of NACO, K Hospital, etc. Furthermore, She is a member of the World Health Organization Expert Advisory Panel. Of course, she is a proud recipient of many awards, such as Dr. K. M. Udupa Award for Excellence in Research in Ayurveda, Excellence in Drug Research Award by Central Drug Research Institute, Dr. B. M. Ghosh Oration of the Indian Pharmacological Society for the topic Herbal Drug Development Opportunities and Challenges, Dr. Farooq Abdullah Oration of SMS Medical College Jaipur on Ethical Issues or in Clinical Research. She has additionally to her credit many publications in both national and international journals on clinical pharmacology. And last but not the least, on a personal front, she is artistically inclined, for she knows to play the sitar. A big round of applause, please. I request Shri Kashkishore Masurkar to kindly present a bouquet to our chief guest. Now, we move on to felicitate our young students. As and when I call your name, please come up on stage and receive your prizes from our eminent chief guest. We start with the STEM standard. For the student obtaining highest number of marks across all boards, we have the prizes: late Sri Shankarrao Ingali Prize, late Sri Ramakrishna Arvind Prize, late Master Arvind Katre Prize, late Sri S.S. Balsekar Prize, late Sri Devidas Lakshman Basroor Prize, late Bandwar Shivshankar Rao and late Srimati Shardabai Bandwar Prize. And the student is Anushka Anand Kupta, who has scored 97.5% in ICSE. Anushka, I request you to stay a while. She is also the recipient of the late Sri S.S. Balsekar Prize for obtaining highest number of marks in ICSE board. Okay. Now for obtaining the highest marks in CBSE, I call upon Advait Nagaran Karnar, who has scored 93%. For obtaining the highest number of marks in English, the prizes are late Srimati Vatabai and late Sri Narayan Ram Adul Prize, late Sri Devita Sri Padukul Prize and Sri Tanur Venkatram Prize. Again, Advait Nagaran Karnar, 96%. Now for the highest marks in Sanskrit, late Srimati Sharda Ji Malapur Prize and late Sri Devita Sri Padukul Prize. This goes to Shraddha Viray Tagar Singh, who has scored a whopping 99%. Now we come to maths. This is one subject I used to run away from in school. Anyway, highest marks in maths for the prizes are late Srimati Sharda Ji Mallapur Prize, late Sri Devadas V. Burukul Prize, late Shivali Ganesh Rao and Srimati Umasundari Prize. Once again, Anushka Anand Kupta, 100% marks. another prize to Anushka for the highest number of marks in Hindi. The prizes are late Punyatma Prabhakar Sharma Seva Mandal, late Punyatma Prabhakar Sharma, and late Rukmabai Talur prize. She has scored 98% in Hindi. But as Kishore Mom said, Saraswat community has always been encouraging the girl child. So we have the girl student obtaining highest number of marks. Anushka Anand Gupta, 97.5%. And the girl student obtaining highest marks in English, the prize is late Srimati Kamla and late Sri Devdas Vishweshwar Padukon prize. Again, Anushka Anand Gupta, 92%. For the student obtaining highest marks in Marathi, the prizes are late Punyatma Prabhakar Sharma Seva Mandal, late Punyatma Prabhakar Sharma, and late Rukmabai Talur prize. This prize goes to Amruta Arvind Sawar, who has scored 91%. Now there are certain KSA special encouragement prizes which are given to all students who have scored above 80% in all boards. The first one name is again Anushka Anand Gupta for ICSE, 97.5%. Vinay Tadese, 97.4% SSE board. Smriti Samir Kumta, 96% ICSE board. Yash Sumant Bichu, 94% SSE board. Anyone who can collect it on Yash's behalf? Okay. Niyati Dinesh Chaudhary, 93.6% SSE. Anyone who can come and collect it on your behalf? Advay Nagadan Karna, 93% CBSE. The next one is Aditya Vishal Balsekar, who scored 92.83% in ICSE. Unfortunately, he couldn't be here today because he has to catch an international flight. The next one is Sankal Shatanand Shukla, 92.84% SSE. Niyati Ajay Pandit, 92% SSE. Ananya Vikram Balbali, 91.4% ICSE. Anybody who can collect it on Ananya's behalf? Amrut Amruta Arvind Savant, 87.4% SSC. And Kamlakshi Swarup Pramanik, 86.4% SSC. We proceed to the HSC board. The student obtaining highest marks in science stream, the prizes are late Sri SS Belsekar Prize and late Master Arvind Katre Prize. To receive the award, I invite Akshat Shamsundar Bhatt, who scored 95.23% in the science stream. For highest marks in commerce stream, the prizes are late Master Arvind Katre Prize, late Sri Sharangar Nadkarni Prize, late Vetramet Mitra Rao Prize, and we give it to Shivam Sandeep Jaggi, 93.38% commerce stream. The late Srimati Vatsala Sabur Prize is for the girl student scoring highest marks in science stream. I call on Gayatri Chimal Chikarmani, who scored 92.46%. Student obtaining highest marks in HSC General, the late Sri Devdas Lakshman Personal Prize goes to Akshat Shamsundar Bhatt, 95.23%. The late Sri Nandan Krishnarao Gokan Prize for highest marks in English goes to Gayatri Chinmay Chikarmani, 88%. Once again, we come to the KSA Special Encouragement Prize, which, as I said earlier, is given to those students who score 80% and above. Akshat Shamsundar Bhatt, 95.23% science stream. Shivam Sandeep Jaggi, 93.38% commerce stream. Gayatri Chinmay Chikarmani, 92.46% science stream. And Shivani Ashish Kagal, 90.9% science stream. Her uncle is here to collect it on her behalf. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we go to CA final. Very tough exam, right? Now, here is one person, Tevalya Ravindra Nadkarni, who's passed it at first attempt, the CA finals. The late Srimati Sulachana and Ratinaman Patiri prize is for him. I call on Soumya Durgesh Kopikar, who in PGTL Finance has stood third. She has scored 8.07 out of 10, aggregate of 2 years. She is doing her management from Wellington Institute of Management, Mumbai. The next is Vinayak M. Yegeli, who is MA LLP, 3 years he's done. CLLB Part 1 and Part 2, as well as Advanced CLLB, so Specialization in Cooperative Banks. He's a member of Bar Council, Mumbai, Goa, and Maharashtra. First class, 66.6% of government board of commercial and higher accounts, Pune and Delhi. He's received specialized certificate in bank management and forex from Institute of Bankers. And he's done a course in journalism and mass communication, as well as customer services codes and ethics. This from the Institute of Finance, Mumbai. Dr. Suman Deepak Murkar, Chief Associate Professor, Department of Textiles and Apparel Designing, SMT Women's University, Mumbai. She has got a 27 years teaching experience. She has presented several publication and research papers at national and international conferences. Her PhD thesis on sourcing and reuse post-consumer clothing waste for technical textile products to the University of Mumbai was awarded for excellence in research category, science and technology. She was felicitated by Kanara Bank in March 2018 for her contribution to the textile industry. She is an honorary secretary board of trustees for the Society of Dyers and Colorist Education. She was on National Advisory Board of International Conferences. She has won a silver medal in quality evaluation of textiles and garments. She was invited as speaker at the International Conference of Materials Recycling in Kottayam in 2014. And she is a visiting faculty at Institute of Chemical Technology, Andhra University and NIFT Mumbai. Let's hear a huge round of applause for our students who have come up with such flying colors. Now I request our chief guest to please share a few words.
Children of Sandhya, then only we will accept you. But I'm sorry, you will probably not be able to do that. So it's probably back to English. There's something just magical about a graduation speech, because you have a captive, perhaps non-attentive group of accomplished students who are about to embark on the next chapter of their lives. I want to start off first by thanking the organizers for inviting me here today. It is truly a homecoming for me. I'm married to a Kokanastha Brahman, as you could understand from my name. I really feel like I'm back in my parental fold. It really feels good. Thank you so much for inviting me. I'm at once taken back to the time when my younger son, Nikhil, had to give a speech in this school for standing first in the 10th standard SSC exam in this school. It is also in what was called a merit list. I don't think such a list exists now. But to come to the point, I told him repeatedly I want him to write the speech, rehearse it with me, and that I would help him to write it. But no. He was now done with school and totally old enough to manage. But what he spoke that day touched a corner in my heart, and I'm going to start by sharing that with you today. He said everybody needs some stress in life. This is what is called eustress, to function optimally. This should not become too much. That is, it should not become distress at any time. He likened it to sun and water for plants. Just like they need the right amount of sun and water to grow, they cannot grow if the sun and water is too little also. And they will burn away with too much sun or drown in too much water. Just like this, you need the right amount of stress, and that is called eustress. And I thought that was such a clever thing to say, and that he was in the 10th standard that time when he said this, or he had just passed the 10th standard. I am of course biologically biased about most things that my boys say or do, but keeping that bias aside, I feel that one of the most important mantras for your life as you move forward is about this eustress. Always remember, eustress, never distress. While preparing for this speech, I thought back to my life and my stresses. How did I cope? I think the most important way I learned to deal with what life threw at me was to put my best foot forward and give my best, whatever the outcome. Some were good, some we won, some were not so good and we lost, some were okay times. But whatever it was, I just went along happily to the next googly that life threw at me, putting my best foot forward. It's a tough life at times, and one of the most important things in this is your family. My family, my husband, mom and our children, and my own mother were the pillars on whom my career rests. Without their love and support, none of this would be possible. And I can't emphasize it less. For example, when my son had chicken pox, it needed both my mom and my mom-in-law to look after this cranky lad, because I was an examiner at a second MBBS exam, and there was no way I was going to get relief from that. I could not tell them, hi, university lad, my son has chicken pox. I mean, that was not an acceptable excuse for anyone, and they were not going to relieve me because you don't find a substitute examiner, and there was a whole lot of students there. So on that day, I could not go there. So it needed my mom and my mother-in-law to look after this cranky fellow. But he also to give him the benefit of doubt, said, okay, ma, you can go. It needs this support to do anything in life. Steve Jobs had said in his Stanford commencement address, he dropped out of college after 6 months and accidentally attended a calligraphy class, which he said helped him to design the typography for the Mac. He said, tongue-in-cheek, of course, that Windows copied this. So according to him, all PCs would not have had the lovely typography they now have if he had not dropped out of college and casually dropped into a calligraphy class. But what's important is what he said after that. He said, you cannot connect the dots looking forward. You can only connect them looking backwards. It all seems to have fitted into place fine, but it was when he was looking backwards. At that time, his parents must have thought, why has he dropped out of college? He thought he was doing the right thing. He's following his heart, probably gone into some calligraphy or whatever he did. But you have to trust that the dots will connect sometime, somewhere. This belief in the future is what took him forward to follow the path his heart dictated, and look where it took him. Another millennial who has changed the world, Mark Zuckerberg, talked about purpose in his Harvard commencement address last year. He said everyone should have some purpose in life. And gave the example of the janitor who JFK, the then president, met when he visited NASA. JFK asked the man, what was he doing? And the janitor said proudly, Mr. President, I am putting a man on the moon. He had a purpose, and even his own cleaning up job contributed to that activity. He owned it. He owned that simple job. And you all, little children, need this purpose. I feel so often that that's what's missing in many children nowadays. A lack of belonging, a lack of purpose. There is nothing lonely in even the janitor's job. Everyone has to do all the jobs that are in the world, and all are important. Maybe as important as Neil Armstrong's, less appreciated maybe, but as Neil Armstrong's was in walking on the moon, if that janitor had not kept the environment clean, how would the engineers have worked or the astronauts trained? So each man's purpose for the job, for whatever is at hand, is I think very important. You need to own your project. I believe even when I was a lonely resident in my department, I tried to own the project so much so that I lived it during the day when I was at work. I feel that this ownership helped me give my best and achieve whatever I have achieved. One last thing I would like to share before I end. In my field, in pharmacology, we do research. It is our research that helps make medicine safe and effective and available for use by everyone. But the sense of gratification is slow. It comes late. We do not get an immediate sense of gratification like a doctor when he is treating a patient and the patient feels better and he says, doctor, you have saved my life. There is an immediate sense of gratification. We don't get that. Nor, for example, a coder, a computer scientist, he codes something and the computer does his bidding. You get a better sense of gratification. But that's taught me this patience. This has taught me patience. You have to wait for it. and you get your sense of gratification, you get your sense of pride and response in due course at some point of time. And the dots, as I said to you about Steve Jobs, will connect at some point or the other in your life. Alexander Fleming discovered penicillin in the most serendipitous way possible. It makes a romantic story. Today, drug development is a slow process, and this is what really counts, that is patience. And this is another quality you should aim at. I think I will end with the words of Senator Elizabeth Warren. She said, "Knowing who you are will help you when it's time to fight. Fight for the job you want. Fight for the people who mean the most to you, and fight for the kind of world you want to live in. It will help when people say that's impossible or you can't do that. Look, if you take the unexpected opportunities when they come up, if you know yourself, and if you fight for what you believe in, I can promise you, you will live a life that is rich with meaning." And I think we should take back Elizabeth Warren's words seriously. Thank you again for having me here and for your patience. And many, many congratulations to all the training you've done so well, and all my good wishes that you will continue to do well in future. Remember, one success, it's like one swallow makes no summer. It's a swallow who does not make a summer. So one achievement, many students who come into medicine, especially in St. Louis Medical College, I'm sorry for maybe 1 minute, it's important to say this when you have succeeded so well, they all feel that they have arrived, they have achieved. You know, it's not so. This is just the beginning of life. And I think what you have achieved today is something really good. It's creditable because it's your effort that you have achieved this through. Just remember to keep it up. And remember not to be too disappointed if life does not throw the same sort of good things that are happening to you in future. It will take care of itself and you will still continue to do well because you are ready and you have the capacity. Well done. Congratulations.
Thank you, ma'am. Those were truly inspiring words, and I'm sure all of us will use it for us in the future. Now, as we come to the end of this program, I call upon Sonia Kopikar to give the vote of thanks on behalf of the students.
Good evening, everyone. It's a pleasure to be here amongst the privilege and pleasure to be among such greats on the dais. Firstly, thank you for inviting me for this presentation. Just to sum it up, I think Urmila Pachi just brought about all my memories growing up. Firstly, Steve Jobs, then Mark Zuckerberg, and I think I'll just add Elon Musk to this because the kind of purpose that he's trying to find with his inventions in renewable resources is something that we all should look forward to and trying to help the environment as well. Then just taking bits and pieces from what Master Pramam said about the community doing well from both men and women doing, taking their responsibilities seriously in terms of education. And firstly, congratulations to the students out here who have outperformed and given it their best shot. And one thing that I feel really happy about is the senior members, Munkar Pachi and Ma'am, who have continued to show that age is not a barrier for education. So I think we have a lot to learn from and continue doing well for ourselves, for the community and for the world at large. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Sonia. If anyone wishes to say something, you can please come up.
A big thank you to KSA for arranging this wonderful convocation. to give a fellow a motivation, a sense of support to each and every student to forge ahead with renewed enthusiasm in his educational field, may it be any profession, that sense of purpose, a dedication, a desire to strive for excellence. I mean, KSA has been doing a phenomenal job, the entire team. Kudos to the spirit of KSA, striving to build and create people generations after generations, meaning that impetus to forge ahead, to create new history, to make a name and ensure that they are a force to be reckoned with. At this moment, I would like to thank each and every one of the KSA, especially Shobana Pachal, the entire team and all the management committee of the KSA for the human work they have done in instilling a sense of team spirit and building that workforce. Urmila Madam has rendered her valued expertise and skill and motivated us to work towards the goal of the future with skill, dexterity and greater ambience. Thank you so much. God bless.
We were just about to end this. However, one student has just come in. Rajshri Hemant Hemani, SSC 70%. Prakash Nam would like to say a few words.
My friends, the reason I'm coming here, I don't know whether the land of the Matai bus is down here, I'm just taking my body in my mind because. As it is to say, at home, here, all our people, and one request I have to make to all the parents and people who are coming, their children, because this is an occasion, every year, the convocation data. It's a great effort to encourage our younger children, because Saraswat, sir, you give so much importance to education. But those that marry, when your child is getting a good felicity, the parents come. My request would be to, even if you don't have somebody from your family to be felicitated here, I would like to see more people here so that we encourage the younger people. And I'm sure there are a lot more students, apart from who are present here today. There are a lot more students who have done good, and for some reason, they are not being able to come, or they have not come, or they wouldn't know about this. So let's popularize this event for the future, because every year when it's unfailingly the KSA has been holding this convention every year. So everybody should look out for the date when the convocation is there, the acronym is there, and encourage, if you know some people who will not be able to remember, if you know that somebody will pass, you can either pass on the information to us and also inform them that there's an event that is happening in Talbukhwani for this communication, and it would be great to have a lot more people coming here and encouraging. I would also request the students who have passed today that next year maybe you are out of college, but if you still come and encourage those who are younger to you, it would be great for everybody. Thank you.
Thank you, Prakash. Now I would like to request Jairam Ma'am to please give a word of thanks.
Good evening. Word of thanks, you know, this is a word which is being used for many years. But I liked last year's Sunil Gundar. He coined one word, one small word. He said, expression of gratitude. I like this much more than word of thanks. I think in future we'll call it as expression of gratitude than word of thanks. You know, word of thanks is a very mundane word it has become now. Anyway, at the outset, let me congratulate all the students who have come up with flying colors. What we saw, 90%, 97%, somewhere it is 100%, 99%, and most of it is more than 90%. I remember when I completed my SSC, more than 60 or 65% used to be one of the outstanding marks which you used to get, but today it is 90s and 95, 100 is something fantastic. Congratulations to all the students for coming out with flying colors in your exams and for your future career. Future studies and career, whatever it is. I think I must congratulate not only the students, I should congratulate the parents as well. Because nowadays, along with the students, parents go through much more stress than the students while their exams are going on or before their exams. Am I right or wrong? So I would like to congratulate all the parents as well for their students coming out with flying colors. So, yes, give a big applause to all the students that come here. Now, coming to this function, Kishore Ma'am, thank you very much because you know this second year succession you are at home during this function. Thank you very much for spending your time over here with us and with the students and with the parents here as well. Now coming to chief guest. Tukrasha Kumar, I mean, you know, can I call Uni? Because for Naswasthiti, whom you want to play the Samani, suddenly if I saw Urmila or Dr. Urmila Thatte, looks very odd, unattractive. So, you know, I thought I prefer calling Uni. Uni is a relation of mine to Jamalabad family and through my wife. So, for last 3 days, I've been calling Uni, so I continue to call Uni even today. That's the man. Okay. Uni, thank you very much for coming for this function. In fact, just for this audience, we have, KSA has been in dialogue with Uni for last 9 or 10 months. They will come as a chief guest. During last March, for the International Women's Day, I spoke to her. Can you be a chief guest on the occasion of the International Women's Day? We had a felicitation program on that particular day. Yeah, it was 10th or 11th of March this year. And she said, I would have loved to come, but we were going somewhere abroad at that time. We talked in February. We were going out of India. So it won't be possible for me. I would have loved to be there as a chief guest. So we kept it in mind. And I think today's function was more appropriate for you to be a chief guest because you know the students, addressing the students and whatever your experience and whatever the what is expected from the students, I think it was much more better function to be the chief guest. Thank you very much to me. Sometimes I wonder, I spoke to you, I said, can you be your chief guest? Yes. But when I started looking at your bio data, it is ever ending. My God, you know that. And she is working on this committee, she is on the ethical committee and some advisory to some so many statutory bodies of the government, whatnot. Anikala Sarkishi, you know, anyway, you know. So I invite her as a chief guest, and how she will find to come on that particular day? That's what I started thinking after I started reading your bio. Anyway, thank you very much for finding some time and being with us. It was nice of you to spend time with the KSA, the students and their parents. I must really thank Umi's family, Mukund, Dr. Mukund Thatte, his her brother, Anand Jamalabad and my Pratibha, and her uncle, Avi Jamalabad and Asha. Ali, okay. Somebody. Okay, yeah, sorry.
Anand, sir.
Aniket, thank you very much, all of you. Very good, but I thought a little more, more number of... I'm talking my wife is not here. Yeah, I'm also a family member. Thank you, Moni. Thanks for your advice to the students as well. in fact, when we look at the students, you know, we sometimes feel that we should, as Dr. Prakash Mankura mentioned just now, we should have many more students to be here with us on this particular function. I don't know what we can do. I think let's discuss this, Shushankar, Kishorman, we will discuss this on our committee meeting. Can we think of the incentive? Give some incentive for coming for this function. Let's give some incentive. So instead of only 17 or 18 students who are coming, of course, we came repeating this work crisis in various other subjects as well. That's how they came many times on the stage. But if we give some kind of incentive, I think this 17 may become even 15. I'm sure that your entire Bombay, minimum 70 to 80 students must be there over, I mean, completed all these studies, you know. So, thank you very much, all the parents and all the people who are coming for this function. Thank you very much. And coming to our committee members, to make a success, it cannot be done by one person. The entire managing committee is help us in making this particular function a success. Along with that, our staff, Shobhana, Swati, Geeta, Ja, Ganesh, and Bhavesh, of course. Bhavesh is not here today. He's not a star, but he is always helping. And our Gandhavadis, who have caged us for this. So, I think I am not missed out. Hopefully, I am not missed out anyone. But thank you very much once again to all of you. And on behalf of Kishorman, our Vice President, I would like to all of you to join for some snacks and coffee or tea. Thank you. Thanks, Mita, for on 26th of November, we have a function called as Foundation Day of KSA. Every year we celebrate only on 26th November because that's the day. That's 107th Foundation Day, which will be celebrated. We will be honoring four eminent personalities of our community and also one young sports personality, and there are some prize distribution of various competitions throughout the year. I think we are drawing kiddies corner, that prize are given on that day. And there is one more addition during this year, is that there is an essay competition for which announcements have come. In the last 2-3 months, these announcements are being made. And those prizes also will be announced. So please be there on 26th November. It's a weekday, but unfortunately we can't change that day. You know, 26th November is always a fixed day for KSA for celebrating Foundation Day. Please be there and please tell your friends, relatives and whoever is there to be present for this function. Thank you very much. Thanks.